Let's look at the hypothalamus anterior pituitary gland axis. So we look at this one, this slice this way. So each trophic hormone from the hypothalamus is going to regulate the another trophic hormone, the hormones have direct functions in the anterior pituitary gland. So we look at this way. So start from the dopamine. Dopamine is a very important neurotransmitter. But here we talk about its endocrine function. It's also a trophic hormone. So dopamine is the trophic hormone. Its function is inhibit prolactin release. Prolactin is the hormone to regulate. It's not a trophic hormone because it have direct function. So definition of trophic hormone is the hormone have no other function except to trigger another hormone release. That's a trophic hormone. So prolactin has direct function. Its function is as the breast cells to develop. So it's not the milk let down, but breast development. This before you have baby, the breast develop, and this prolactin. And dopamine will actually inhibit. So dashed line, you see dashed line, this inhibition. So more dopamine actually inhibit prolactin release, and less the breast development. Now let's look at the metabolizing pathway. Start from the TRH. TRH is the hypothalamus, release TRH. You're gonna go to the anterior pituitary gland, trigger the TSH release. TSH will go to the thyroid gland, trigger the T3, T4 release. So this is a trophic hormone. That's another trophic hormone because TSH, its function is trigger T3, T4. And that's not a trophic hormone because they have direct function. It works on the cells, increase metabolizing rate. And we can also look at this way. So TRH, it will increase prolactin release. So increase the TRH release will increase prolactin release, and it will increase the breast development. So we can look at this way, we can look at this way. Now let's look at the stress hormone pathway. When you see a bear coming towards you, and this pathway will be activated. Start from CRH. Hypothalamus release CRH, corticotrophin releasing hormone. It will go to the ACTH, go to the anterior pituitary gland, trigger ACTH, another trophic hormone. It will go to the adrenal cortex, release cortisol. Cortisol is the one that has a lot of function in the body, will increase your blood sugar level, so you are ready to fight. So there's this one, this pathway. And now let's look at the growth hormone. During puberty, this is the pathway being activated. Start from the hypothalamus, release GHRH. Will go to the anterior pituitary gland, trigger the growth hormone release. Growth hormone can be the trophic, can be not the trophic hormone. If it's not the trophic hormone, it will directly work on the body tissues and waste the cells to grow. But it can also work like a trophic hormone. It will go to the liver and trigger the insulin-like growth factor to release. And it will ask the cells to grow. So either this way or this way. Somatostatin, this is the one inhibit growth hormone release. When you have more somatostatin, you actually inhibit the growth hormone release and will inhibit this pathway. Now let's look at the sex hormone pathway. The sex hormone pathway starts from the hypothalamus. During puberty, you're going to release the gonadotropin releasing hormone, GnRH. It will activate two hormone release from the anterior pituitary gland, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone. Both male and female have these two. They use the function in female's body to name these two hormones. It will go to the gonad. So the male is going to trigger the androgen release. And that's the testosterone. This is the main androgen. In female, going to trigger the estrogen and progesterone release. Estrogen make the female look like female. Going to have those sexual characteristics. Progesterone mainly regulate the menstrual cycle. And that's this response. So you can have a short pathway or 1, 2, 3. You can have two or you can have three. Both of them, the long pathway, that's this. So let's take them out. So the pathway in the anterior pituitary gland could be complicated. So if we talk about, prolactin release, that's this one, right? So hypothalamus, first integrating center, and anterior pituitary gland trigger prolactin. That's the second integrating center. Or if we talk about the, say, the stress hormone pathway, you have 1, 2, 3 integrating centers. So let's use the stress hormone pathway as an example. Say you see a bear coming towards you. Okay, that's the stimulus, visual stimulus. And this stimulus will go to your sensory neuron. Your eye gonna send a signal, go to your brain integrating center, first integrating center. So that's the sensory neuron, also called the efferent, first efferent, efferent 1, will go to the integrating center 1. Your hypothalamus release CRH, so that's the neural hormone, so this one is neural hormone, CRH. CRH will be carried by the blood, go to the anterior pituitary gland, your integrating center 2, and this is the endocrine, so it's the E1, endocrine 1, but it's actually integrating center 2. So the integrating center can be the neuron structure, can be the endocrine structure. So this integrating center 2, that's the in the anterior pituitary gland, gonna release ACTH. ACTH will be transported by the blood, will go to your integrating center 3, and that's the endocrine 2, that's the second endocrine organ, that's your anterior pituitary gland, will trigger the second hormone release, that's the cortisol. Cortisol gonna be transported to your whole body, so your whole body responds to the stress hormone cortisol. And the target will be your body cells, your muscle, your cells. And also the fat cell, adipose cells, they're gonna turn the fat, lipolysis, turn the fat into glucose. And also your liver gonna release those glycogen, turn the glycogen into glucose, because no matter you want to fight the bear or you want to run away from the bear, your muscle gonna use a lot of glucose, produce ATP. So a quick response is your glucose level start to increase. That's the response. So either two integrating center, we talk about the prolactin pathway, or three integrating center, we talk about the stress hormone pathway, or the growth hormone pathway, or the a growth hormone pathway can be either this one or this one, right? Because the growth hormone can directly have response, or it can trigger the liver produce the insulin growth factor. That's this one. Or the sex hormone pathway, that's definitely this one. So either one of them, the pathway is very complicated. It's a long loop. And the hormone concentration need to be well maintained. Hormones are the chemical molecule. You have very small concentration can have a huge effect. So every time we talk about those small, powerful molecule, their concentration need to be well maintained. And to well maintain it, negative feedback. So we need to use negative feedback to maintain it. And because this hormone system is so, concentration is so well maintained, if you start to mess up this system, you can expect some side effects. So we do have people, they have a hormones dysfunction, or their hormones concentration either too high or too low, they have disease, or they do it on purpose. Like we have people, they self-inject testosterone to make the male look like a male, right? And this function of testosterone. So they're gonna have a big muscle, but the side effect, they start to mess up this system, they can expect some side effect. And the concentration of each hormone need to be well maintained. So let's still use the stress hormone pathway as an example. So stimulus trigger the CRH, hypothalamus. CRH, traffic hormone, release, go to the anterior pituitary gland, release ACTH. It will go to the target gland, release cortisol. Okay, there's hormone 3. They're gonna go through the negative feedback. So you have the short loop, means the ACTH, they can inhibit hypothalamus. Say when you have too much, they will say, okay, don't release that much. And we have cortisol, they're gonna have a receptor in the hypothalamus, anterior pituitary gland, and say, okay, slow down because you're gonna go out of control. And that's negative feedback. And to maintain it, we focus on the long loop. We focus on the long loop, especially in the discussion exercise when we talk about the disease, like which hormone's label is too high, too low, we use the long loop. Means this increase gonna trigger this increase, when this increase gonna trigger this increase, and this increase will negative feedback inhibit this. So eventually they are well maintained. And if this go out of control, can be hyposecretion or hypersecretion. Could be this person has a tumor, in the hypothalamus, and could be this tumor kill those cells, so it can cause the hyposecretion, say hyposecretion of CRH, or can be hypersecretion. You have a tumor in the pituitary gland and trigger the cells release hormone like crazy. Could be the hypersecretion. Could be either one of them, and could be the more diagnosed if this problem happens in the final gland. So if it is a CRH pathway, if this problem happens in the adrenal gland, we call it the primary pathology. If it happens in the hypothalamus or in the anterior pituitary gland, we call it the secondary pathology. So it could be the primary, it could be secondary. So it happens in the trophic hormone. And you will have more practice in the discussion exercise. Okay, let's stop the lecture.